Hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, also known as HCM, can potentially lead to debilitating symptoms and serious complications if not addressed. So, it's really important that healthcare providers have an index of suspicion for HCM and diagnose it early. But how do we know when an echocardiogram should be ordered to confirm HCM? There are a few big signs that can help you make a more informed decision. Typical symptoms of HCM include exertional chest pain, shortness of breath, and fatigue. Individuals may also experience palpitations, presyncope, and/or syncope. While these symptoms are common to many different cardiac pathologies, in patients with HCM, they are often dynamic, meaning patients may tell you they have good and bad days, or that their symptoms are often worse following a heavy meal or on hot days. Another clue may be an abnormal physical exam. In about two-thirds of patients with HCM, there will be dynamic left ventricular outflow tract obstruction, which will cause some characteristic findings on physical examination. You may feel a pulsus bisphenoides. You'll also hear a harsh mid-systolic murmur that will be accentuated by provocation, such as during the strain phase of the Valsalva maneuver or when standing from squatting. You'll also want to pay attention to the ECG. About 90% of patients with HCM will have an abnormal ECG. While there are no pathognomonic findings, we'll often see deep T-wave inversions in the anterior or lateral leads, or ST segment changes and Q waves. Finally, if your patient identifies a first-degree relative, meaning parents, siblings, or children with HCM, you should order an echocardiogram for screening purposes, even if your patient has no symptoms. So, if your patient is showing typical symptoms or suggestive findings on their physical exam with or without abnormal ECG, or a family history of HCM, an echocardiogram should be performed to help confirm a diagnosis of HCM. To learn more, visit asecho.org/HCM.